is once he's done it, like this, when that foot comes down, don't put it down and then look for the strike, do it at the same time. So again, he throws a punch, and last one, two, three, four, and look. You know, it dings his arm. Every single time you touch a guy, fucking hurt him. Okay, every single time. Even in training, we're all gonna have bruises on our arms, we're all gonna be a little bit fucked up. But it does two things. You'll know it works because when you're throwing just a light punch at your partner, it'll hurt your arm. And you'll also know you can do it. So you know it is effective because it was done to you, and then you'll do it to your partner, and he'll go, all right, that was a little bit of that. Good, okay, now we understand. Because you should never take anything that I say, or Lee says, or Jamie says, or Tom says, for granted. You should never say, Michelle says, hey, do this. You would just go, okay, Michelle said, be a non-believer, okay? You say, I'm going to have to feel it, and then I'm going to have to do it in order to own it. Okay, so, okay, you want that little bit of a flash. Don't do this technique. I want you to do that down first, this one. Boom, first, and then do back and back. When you do this one here, see how I'm hitting this bicep like I showed you? I'm turning my arm like that to shrug him in. At the same time he comes in, he's coming right in to the vagus. This is a real quick, hard, but understanding it's never going to be as hard as a true accent. Okay? So on this one, all you're doing again, you're stepping with the side that you throw. Alright? So now it's not the opposite side. Now it's the side you're throwing. So if I'm squared up flat, or even if I'm like this, okay, I'm going to step with the same foot that I'm throwing. Okay, to him. You don't try to step behind him on this one. You're not going too deep. All I'm trying to do is impact the neck to make the guy's hands fly up and drop his chin. Alright, to knock him off balance. Alright, so the hold for this, you just have the pad, any pad. I want you to just hold it right here. All I want you to do is step in and just right here. Boom. Okay, let's try that one. Diagonal, because the space I'm trying to reach is right here. So if he puts his shoulder up like in a way, boom, it still gets through. I still get jawbone, I still get head, right? So if I'm lazy and I'm just driving like this, it ain't gonna do anything. You're gonna shove him, it's not gonna hurt him. So get that arm diagonal, just like this. Okay, make sure that the attitude of the arm is right.
Head high. Head high.
Again, if my forearm hits, good. If my elbow hits, good. If my fist hits, it's all good. All right? So all you're doing again is I'm going to step through. And all you're doing is here. See the twist and the movement. The most common error on this one is guys will fall away. So they'll twist. But their weight's going over their left shoulder. You want to step across and bring it this way. Okay, so I'm here. A little bit of a whip to get the hand motion back, and then step across. This hand stays up right in the guard. The long cupped hand blow would be just like I was fading away. I drop this hand down here along my leg, and then I'm just going to like throw that cricket ball, right? So I'm here, I might put my hand out to move away from a guy, and it comes back. On this one, leave a little bend in your elbow. If you straighten your elbow all the way like this, your shoulder's gonna continue. You can actually hyperextend your elbow on. Remember, you're hitting a hard surface, right? So you wanna make sure that you have a little bit of a bend to your elbow when you do this. So again, we'll do short and long. From here, okay, both. The traditional World War II application, a la John Kerry, John McSweeney, and all that, is this arc like this, right? Well, if you think about it, that's not ergonomic. It's hard to keep my hand bent back in line with his center core direction. It doesn't work, right? The other reason it doesn't work is only at one point in this arc that I actually touch his chin, because it's a curve, right? It goes like this. So it's real easy to miss that shot because guys just do this and your hand goes right by him, okay? So we don't do the traditional chin jab. The other thing about a chin jab is guys will always finish it up with like an eye gouge face match takedown. If you do a chin jab properly, he's nowhere near you anymore. You just fucking snapped his neck and you got it horizontal. Alright, so a lot of times guys will do this, they'll go up, now this, now take him down. If you did that, you did not chin jab. A jab is a shot, okay?
So we've altered it. The way that we do it is we turn our hands sideways. And it's a chin jab, you're still trying to go to the point of the chin, but the rest of your hand will come up along the jawline. All right, that way it's ergonomic. So now if I'm here, if I'm doing this, it comes just like this, I'm still gonna wanna fucking shove his head into the next country. All right, so Lee's gonna turn his head to the side, move it out of the way. This is what actually is happening. All right, that's how deep I'm gonna go with this strike. All right, I'm not gonna stop at his chin and I'm not gonna pull it back. I'm literally trying to fucking boom in here and then drive him like that with plyometric intensity. Alright, so when you train with this, please, like I said, you just gotta bite down a little bit. I'm here, you start position 4, you start position 3, check the arm, and come in. Your shoulder ought to be past him because you're stepping through it. Alright, do a couple that way, stop and touch. Okay, and then have your partner turn his head to the side. I want your armpit to hit his
start wanting to use their strength. So they'll get in this position.